Hello and welcome back to Astrological Intentions. I am your host, Alex Reavy, along with the extraterrestrial expert herself, Sandy Reavy.
Hi, Alex.
So this is episode 56 and it is August 19th here in the Jazz Fuzz studio. We're going to get straight into the transits. August 21st, Venus ingress Virgo.
Perfect as possible.
August 21st, Mercury trine Jupiter.
Uplift others today.
August 23rd, Sun ingress Virgo.
Attention to detail.
And happy birthday, Virgos. August 24th, Venus conjunct Mars.
Reset expectations.
And then Sandy has some finished talismans she'd like to talk about. The Venus Kazemi Sun, as well as the Moon in Pisces square Jupiter. However, there are none upcoming.
Nope.
Then on the horizon, we give you a little snippet of the Dr. Laura and Sandy radio show. And we're going to talk about our Phoenix, Arizona trip, the Global Gathering, the Constellation Bracelet Workshop, the Wanderlust Festival, and the Unhustle Retreat. So stay tuned for that. Then our house, we are going to be talking about a very special tooth filing ceremony that I was about to have but backed out last minute. And then how Huggy Time is catching on, Amelia Earhart's airplane crash may be discovered shortly, and Sandy's mishap about Mars on the ascendant. So stay tuned for this episode of Astrological Intentions.
You got the keys. You got the keys. You got the keys. You got the keys.
Hello, Mama. Hello.
Hi, Alex.
Extraterrestrial expert.
Oh, you know, it feels like that because we are coming in tonight. It was like raindrops. It actually felt really good.
Yeah, it kind of cools it off a bit.
Yeah, so it felt good to feel that. Sky, air, and water coming down.
Yes. And so I want to go direct with everybody and just let you know that the Body, Mind, Spirit Expo tickets were claimed just a couple hours after our episode went live. And so thank you guys all for, you know, all of your messages.
And paying attention. We really appreciate it. We got a lot of different kind of reach outs. Or responses, maybe, is the word I'm looking for.
Yes, and I do have one, actually, from the Wanderlust show that we did a few weeks ago. Can I start with it?
Dun-da-da-dun, going direct.
Okay.
Let's hear it.
She says, this is Emily, she says, hi, Sandy and Alex. I first want to say thank you. Thank you for your amazing energy and taking the time to connect with me at Wanderlust Squaw Valley. I attended two of your classes, booked a reading with Sandy, and started listening to your podcast. Mm-hmm. I love the podcast. I've only been listening for 2 weeks, but it helps me tune in for the week ahead. On this week's Ladybug episode, you recommended taking a different route to work on Monday because of Sun Square Uranus. I was already on a different route before listening and felt so connected when I heard your recommendation. I'm so inspired by you both, and I am so excited to learn more about astrology and my own chart as a tool for wellness and self-reflection. I'm reaching out to ask you if you have any recommended resources for learning. There's a ton of information on Google and it's super overwhelming. Are there any websites or authors or other resources that you'd recommend? I would love to have more foundational knowledge before my reading with Sandy next week. Thanks for taking the time to connect, and I hope your family, Huggy Time, was loving and amazing and all of the good things. All of the best, Emily.
Emily, you really bring like beautiful tears to my eyes that you really are, you know, aligning here and then spending time to, you know, it's like a thank you note.
Right.
Who does thank you notes anymore other
than
Jimmy Fallon and gets paid for it, right? So thank you for the thank you note.
Yeah.
That's really, really sweet. Very sweet.
And it's funny too that you say thank you for the thank you note because I have, anytime I do get a thank you note for mm-hmm. like a wedding present or a thank you note for reaching out to somebody or helping them, I always want to send back a thank you note, and I did it for the first time. And I just thought it was so funny because that's not a normal thing anymore. It's like, I got to send them a text message. And it really only takes just a few moments to send
I mean,
that?
It does take about 5 minutes, let's be real. Okay. And then you got to lick it and get their address and then the stamp.
Oh, I'm just talking about a text message.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Right.
Like the time it takes in the
But it's way cooler to have a thank you note.
Oh, yeah. The wherewithal it takes to put that time in and your pen to paper and the lick of your stamp on the corner.
Right.
And then, you know, delivering it, walking out into the mailbox. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's all thought out time for somebody. And they know when they've received that card, that little thank you. It's like somebody thought.
It's so energetic. Yes.
This for me.
And so, Emily, again, thank you so much for your thank you note, for your thank you email. It is very well received. And of course, all of you out there, we love to hear back from you. So please keep them coming. Even if you've sent emails before, it is not redundant. We love to hear it.
And I'll work on some resource books. I'll bring them and I'll report next episode.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Okay.
So, okay, let's just head straight into the transits.
I want to remind everybody that Jupiter, that has been retrograde for the last 4 months since April, is, you know, stationed direct. So it's just kind of starting, it's made the turn, moving forward. We love Jupiter when it's moving forward. You know, we like it when it's retrograde, but we love it. So it brings a sense of hopefulness, positivity, that there's something to look forward to. There's, you know, things are starting to maybe brighten, right? There's more generosity maybe in the world, maybe a little busyness. I know that when we were coming here tonight, I'm like, oh my God, there's so many people out in the world, right?
Yeah.
From point A to point B.
I think that all the time.
No, but I really noticed it. And I think it's maybe that the energy, right? Like there's more stuff going on.
There's an uptick. And also I just want to make a quick aside about Jupiter moving direct in its own sign Sagittarius. We are bringing back our Jupiter in Sagittarius workshop. And this is an online workshop. So you can do this from anywhere in the world. And the last time we did it, we had an incredible group of wonderfully supportive people and people who were doing, you know, kind of big stuff like publishing and getting Washington, D.C. turned around and the government and everyone was there to support one another in their big ideas.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, no idea is big enough for Jupiter in Sagittarius.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are curious about that workshop and you have not received the email yet.
Well, you wouldn't have because we don't even... I've got two possible dates. I think they might be in November. You don't like the November date time period?
I think it might be too far away. However, email me and I'll get you on a very special list where you'll be the first to find out. So info@intentionbeads.com and we will get you on that very special list.
Yes. I mean, this is going to be the second time we've run this webinar. We did it last year when Jupiter went into Sagittarius. And then we're coming back with it right before Jupiter leaves Sagittarius.
Right. And it's even like a re-engaging. Mm-hmm. So like even the people who were there and a part of this workshop when Jupiter first ingressed into Sagittarius, there might be some more gears that we need to start turning and getting in motion now. You know, and so bring those malas out that we made, bring them back into the circuit
mm-hmm.
and even like, you know, join us during this time because we're going to pick a very, of course, very powerful time to have this webinar and workshop and get back on.
What
those
did
big
you mean,
ideas.
Mala? Tell me more about that mala you just mentioned.
So the mala, Sandy, you hand make a talisman for each person and you get to...
One bead.
Yes, one bead. And what we do, and it's very apropos for Jupiter, once we have that bead finished during that webinar where we're teaching you all about Jupiter in Sagittarius, what it means, how to set an intention that's a big, big idea.
To their personal chart.
To your personal chart. And we send those beads over to Bali. They get finished, blessed in a Balinese temple into an incredible mala with the tassel color of your choice.
With the Rudraksha seed beads.
And with the Rudraksha seed beads. And then they get shipped around the other side of the world. So as Jupiter would have it, and Jupiter and Sagittarius of international travel, it's like a whole trip around the world.
The globe.
Mm-hmm. Right. Oh my gosh. And that reminds me of the Amelia Earhart article I just read. So I'll talk about that in our house.
Okay. Lots going on. Let's get into transits.
On. Yes.
Okay. So yes, reminder, just last week, Jupiter went direct. So watch for those positive, hopeful times again. But also remember that the next day, the planet Uranus stays in retrograde. So this stays in retrograde until the first or second week in January of 2020. And so when Uranus, you know, this whole time, you know, this is all through this half part of August all the way through about the second week in January, you know, have time to adjust what is going on, because Uranus does bring up new things suddenly, spontaneously, unexpectedly. So it kind of can be a little bit of restlessness. So when it's going retrograde, you know, kind of gather yourself, you know, try to ground what has already occurred for you, particularly if you have any birthdays that have that early, like the first, really first 6 days of any birthdays of Taurus, mm-hmm. or any of those early birthdays in the opposite sign, which is Scorpio, or any of those other fixed signs, which would be squares, early signs of Leo or Aquarius. So those are the sun signs. But if you know your chart, we've been printing a ton of charts, at least a couple hundred for people so that they can listen and follow on the podcast. So when I give this information, you'll be able to look to see, do you have any planets in any of those from 0 to 6 degrees in any of those fixed signs? Those planets are getting hit by Uranus. And now Uranus is retrograde. So it's kind of releasing a little bit so that you can have time to, you know, fix, mend, or adjust.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So anyway, okay, continuing on from today.
Yay.
So our first transit is Wednesday, August 21st, and it's when Venus ingresses into Virgo.
Right. And you named this one Perfect as Possible. Or as possible.
Perfect as possible.
As possible.
Yeah. Well, this is the beginning of the Virgo season. Mars is already in Virgo at this point. It went in like yesterday. So, you know, here we go into this Virgo season. This is at 4:07 in the morning on Wednesday. And Venus is moving into her fall, which means it's not a happy place for Venus. Relationships need to get very practical. You know, how fun is that? where, you know, they need to be meaningful, that there's like a possible critical analysis. So use that critical eye, you know, that detailed eye to benefit this relationship and not to diminish your partner. Right? Because, you know, when you're looking at something and things askew, like something is askew on the wall, you know, you want to immediately go up and fix it. But when you're talking about someone else that you're relating to, you just can't go up and, you know,
tilt their head.
tilt their head and have them, or cut their hair, or, you know, critically disapprove of something.
Yeah.
So it's a time for, you know, allowing that, you know, perfection is in progress. And what is perfection anyway? You know,
right. Because to me, this reminds me a lot of something like a paint by numbers type of thing, where Venus is all about artistry and beauty, mm-hmm. and Virgo is all about methodology. And, mm-hmm. you know, this number corresponds with this little paint color, and you get it in this, you know, tight little plastic piece. And, mm-hmm. you know, so it's, you know, where an artist wants a palette and they want to be mixing and ebbing and flowing in these interdimensional colors, Virgo kind of wants to keep the lines between them. Mm-hmm. And you start with number one and you don't mess it up.
And you don't change color.
Right.
Right. So really, yeah, it's about getting, you know, real. So, you know.
So this could be a great time too to like set boundaries.
Yeah. We'll wait till we get to the end of the week.
Okay.
Yeah. And that's a really good time. So as a reminder, Mars moved into the Virgo place yesterday, you know, where our actions are already moving in that direction. So, you know, if this is good for disciplined work, right? Mars in Virgo is like, Mars is okay. And it's not in its detriment. It's not in its fall. It's not in its exaltation, nor is it in its domicile. So it's kind of neutral here.
Right. So just to quick relay the message, different planets have their favorite signs. Mm-hmm. And where Venus is not necessarily besties with Virgo, Mars actually has a better correspondence mm-hmm. there. Okay. Yeah.
And that's where that you know, detailed daily routine where mm-hmm. Mars says, okay, what do I need to do? How can I fire up myself? So, you know, again, Mars just went in yesterday. So if you need to be put on a plan of some sort, routine for health, get into it, right? And Venus moves in and says, I really just want the romance of it. But okay, you know, if I'm going to do this, I want to do this in making sure that I'm doing it correctly.
And what a send off to the Virgo season. Okay, so the next one, Mercury trine Jupiter.
So we got a trine. This happens an hour later. This is at 5:05 a.m. still on Wednesday, the 21st. And uplift others today, right? Because, you know, Mercury is in the sign of Leo. Now, interesting. Mercury is in its fall, meaning not so happy in the sign of Leo. Because Mercury is the communication and details, and it's in a trine to Jupiter that is in its domicile, right, mm-hmm. in Sagittarius. So Sagittarius is ruled by Jupiter. So that's very happy. And so, you know, the details, the Mercury, the detail, the communication, the figuring out things is in trine to seeing the big picture of Jupiter. So, you know, this Mercury in Leo, you know, may think and speak a little bit dramatically, right? So the Jupiter is expanding that to be more philosophical and excite others on a personal level and personal growth.
Okay, I like that a lot. And so, I mean, overall, I think this is a wonderful day to really go out of your boundaries. Jupiter would want you to do that and communicate. So is there someone that you would like to, you know, just send some support that you have, that you've been meaning to, that you have, you know, you're in your busy life, just been able, you know, to focus on yourself, but maybe this is a time just a quick pen, a thank you card, or maybe even just a, we'll create something new. It's called a, you can do it card and send it to one of your good friends, just as a reminder of, hey, I want to uplift you today. I'm in your corner. I'm cheering you on. I know you're battling a big, you know, Goliath here, whatever it is. And I'm here.
But what if you did it with your partner? Because an hour earlier, remember the Venus had gone into that sign of Virgo. So it's like, you know, I really want to make sure that I am pleasant. Mm-hmm. And not critical. I want to be helpful and in service, not, you know, critical.
Right. And so maybe just a love note of what they're doing right.
Yeah.
Like, cool.
Yeah. That's a great idea.
All right. I like that. And then we have Friday, August 23rd, Sun ingress into Virgo. It is Virgo season. And happy birthday, all you Virgos.
Happy birthday. This happens at 5:02 a.m., attention to detail, just like that. You know, it's time to be specific. It's time to articulate what you do, what you say, what you like. Every little piece of the day needs to be, you know, focused and detailed. You know, Virgo is an earth mutable. So the sun is just coming out of the sign prior to that, which is Leo. And it's finishing up the fire fixed sign and moving into a completely different modality in a different element. And it's now having to get on a track of earth mutable. So, you know, there's more grounding here. There's feels grounding, organized. You know, your plans are going, are following through.
Mm-hmm.
But this allows to be planned. It allows for some flexibility and some movement within this. So get your daily routine into shape. That's really what this is. What
this whole season is about. That's that back to school, you know, happenings that we're doing is like sharpen your pencils, get your folders organized and labeled, and, you know, get your textbooks together, stack them in your shelves or put them in your backpack.
Yeah, it's time to prepare for seriousness.
Right.
Yeah, on us all. And I know we feel it. We smell it in the air when you're up here in the northern part of the North America, right? We can smell this air coming in. And interesting, I just read something about those that have either like a moon in Virgo or sun in Virgo or Virgo rising. They, because their ruler is Mercury, and I knew this, they tend to look younger than their age.
Oh, interesting.
So, happy birthday, you young-looking Virgos.
Yeah, happy birthday.
Yeah.
So, okay, great. Is there anything else?
No, that's all I have on that Friday.
Okay, and then we also have Saturday, August 24th, Venus conjunct Mars.
Yeah, so this happens at just around noon, 12:04 p.m. on Saturday, and this is at 4 degrees of Virgo. So, yeah, you know, Mars went in earlier in the week, then Venus is hot on its trail. Venus is a faster-moving planet, so Venus was applying. Here, she comes up and conjuncts the Mars. So, reset expectations, and the reason why I titled that is because it's in Virgo. Again, let's remind you, Venus is in its fall.
Right.
Mars is neutral. It's in better shape in the sign of Virgo. So it's asking you to blend, you know, blend these two energies together. It's the female, right, energy of the sky, and it's the masculine energy of the sky, and they're in a dance. So because they're together, they're touching each other. So, you know, you blend the charm and beauty with some energy, you know, and it's romance, right? So this Virgo asks for improvement, though. Like, what can we do on a daily basis that improves the way that we have, you know, kind of commit to one another, reestablish expectations so that your personal desires are aligned with your partner? And your partner's desires are aligned, you know, with your, what you can give and take, right? Because that's Mars and Venus energy is, Mars is the giver and Venus is the receiver. So, because you don't want to use the lower energy here, where you tend to be more critical or off-put because things aren't going your way, or the right thing wasn't said at the right time, or the garbage wasn't taken out when you, like whatever it is, you can get really picky during this time.
Interesting.
So reset expectations. It's something that should be done often anyway, because as we are all growing on personal levels, particularly with our partners, that we get to see, you know, how I can, you know, ask for more. Or how I can give more. You know, take it up a notch. Take it up a notch all the time.
Right. And so, yeah, there's that responsibility, too, that if we are asking more from our partner, that we also need to be willing to hear the criticism and rise to the occasion as well.
You know, there's a thing that I was taught years ago by, actually, I think it was one of my customers at SheBeads. And they said that the best way to have a conversation when you want to achieve something very important or to answer a very important question is you do plus, plus, minus, plus.
Mm-hmm.
Remember we used to do that? We used to try it out, but it took some practice. And the plus, plus, minus, plus means you say four phrases or four sentences and you start with a positive, positive. Then you go to the main thing, the you know, the adjustment. and then ended up with a positive. So it would go something like, let's play with that for a second. Are you down?
Sure.
Like, you look so nice today, Alex. You know, I love that outfit you have on that I mentioned to you earlier. I just would think that you would, you know, wear a different type of sports bra with that. But I just love that gold imprint on the front. Did you hear it?
Oh,
plus,
yeah.
Plus, minus, plus.
Yeah. Punch to the gut.
So plus. Really, did that hurt? Are they like, why did you wear that sports bra with that outfit?
I still feel pretty, so thank you. Thank you very much.
It's kind of that, if you got into that plus, plus, minus, plus during this week, like this whole week, then you're able to understand that, you know, you can say it softer.
Right.
With more, better response, right?
Yeah, and it makes it a little bit more receptive.
Exactly.
Instead of going for the jugular.
Yeah, going for the sports bra.
You're massaging the shoulders before you go with the jugular. Okay, yeah. So should we head into talisman times?
Yeah, let's
okay.
go.
Well, disclaimer, there are no upcoming talismans, but we are going to talk about the two that Sandy just finished. First, we'll discuss the moon in Pisces squared Jupiter.
Well, let me tell you the one I just finished.
Oh, sure. The Venus Kazemi.
Yeah, that was first. That was
okay,
first.
Perfect.
So I did that Tuesday, August 13th at 11:04 a.m., Venus Kazemi, the sun, to invoke the power of the goddess. As an empowered woman, I get to the heart of the matter of my beautiful and authentic self-expression. Of that, I am sure.
That's just like female power right there.
Wow.
I mean, the feminine standing and being present and wanting to be heard.
I mean, I did this when Venus was, you know, Venus is moving pretty fast right now. And so it crossed the sun and it was within that 17 minutes of arc, which is a very specific, limited time where the sun is in the heart of the Venus is in the heart of the sun, mm-hmm. where everything is calm and where everything is beautified. Is that a word?
Yeah.
Well, I do change words. So that empowerment, and it's in what the sun is in Leo, was in Leo at this time. So it was this, Libra was rising. It made Venus the ruler of the whole chart, moved into the center of the Leo sun. So there is this, you know, authentic self-expression, this beautifying goddess of feminine power.
Right.
And
absolutely.
That, I am sure.
and that's so funny too. I like this a lot. And what it does remind me too, you know, Venus Kazemi the sun, it's kind of like Burning Man, you know, and Burning Man is happening, you know, pretty soon. I think it starts on the 25th. And, you know, this is a moment to realize that, you know, we can create things, but there will always be, you know, this like where it will go up in flames. There will be an end to it. And yeah, I think that too, where Venus, that art, and that Kazemi, the sun, kind of like bursting, and that incredible release and that expression, and not necessarily trying to control and hold.
Well,
that
even
art.
Even holding on to any, you know, attachments that have, you know, hurt or maimed or, you know, slowed down that Venusian quality.
Right.
So it was like burning off.
Yes.
All of those negative attachments that we don't need anymore.
Right.
So, you know, yeah. The empowerment of the goddess.
Yes. And so the moon in Pisces squared Jupiter, that one, the intention is to increase concern and around social and individual justice. Talk to us a little bit about this one.
Yeah. Now is the time. I take action to protect those who have been hurt. Really interesting here, this I made on Friday, August 16th at 2:23 p.m. We had, you know, the sun was in the very last little bit of the Leo.
Mm-hmm.
We had the moon in Pisces, and the ascendant was Sagittarius. Well, you know, Jupiter is the ancient ruler of Pisces, and it's the current ruler of Sagittarius. So the moon in this configuration was linking, it was like in this reception. And this is why I went for it, because it was such a powerful time to, you know, bring information around social, like community justice, yet individual justice. Because the moon is about self, our body, how we feel, our emotions, and Jupiter is for
the masses,
the everyone. Yeah.
So, okay.
Yeah. And then none, I'm not doing any of this coming week. We are, you know, going to be out of town for the weekend, and I'll be busy doing things that I can't make talisman. And I'm not packing the oven. I'm not packing the razor blades and all of the clay.
Right.
Yeah, so I'm not making any talismans. I'll let you know on Instagram if I do find another time that speaks to me that I don't
and
have
And also,
out.
I mean, there is the incredible opportunity to come in and work one-on-one with Sandy. And there's two ways you can do that. One is the personal intention bracelet. And that is a very, you know, coveted item that that you can really truly customize one-on-one with Sandy, as well as the constellation bracelet workshop, where you're making 12 different intentions all in one bracelet, where we kind of create a constellation of a bracelet and we give it this theme. We give it this purpose and this meaning. And both are incredibly...
Come on. We start that constellation bracelet workshop on the new moon, August 30th. And I know the first time is at 9:40 a.m. And then we finish mid-October. And all of those dates are on the website, intentionbeads.com. The dates and the times are listed there.
Right. And so you can find that link to that page in this description. So let's move straight into On the Horizon, because we'll
already been there.
Yeah, we dabbled in. So I wanted to quick mention that the Dr. Laura Berman radio show Uncovered has been so much fun to do for you, Sandy. And I wanted to include a short snippet here of some recordings that you two have done and people that you've helped with. So let's do that. Let's do a quick roll of that here.
Get involved in some charitable, purposeful something. Take something on that you're not only planning, but you're planning for purpose, you know?
Yeah.
And I think that will really help. And do those mindfulness kind of getting in the moment, not focusing on where you should be, but where you are right now. Mm-hmm. And really being in that, I think, as a life practice, that's going to be super important for you. Okay, my love?
Okay.
Let us know what happens.
Really, really insightful. I am type A.
And soon to be a recovering type A, just like yours truly.
Wow. I didn't even like, this like answered a lot more questions than I even thought that I had. So,
as we tend to do on Uncovered Radio, we tend to get a lot more and often not even the answer to the question you asked, but hopefully you got that too. Good luck to you. You call too. If you need some help, you want to talk to me and our optimistic astrologer, Sandy Reeby, give us a call.
Dr. Laura and I have fun, and we really give great advice from two different perspectives. And really, it's great takeaways. It's like next steps. We give dates, and we give suggestions. And, you know, actually, we have you sometimes call back in a 4-month period. And
they're quick touch points, you know, because
they're things that you can actually do.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. And there's books you can read or whatever.
It's about getting to the point, especially, you know, Dr. Laura is really wonderful at that, where she can, you know, just ask you the pertinent questions and then get down to the basics. And so if you wanted to be on the Dr. Laura Uncovered Radio show, make sure to email questions@uncoveredradio.com. Next, we have our Phoenix, Arizona trip happening August 23rd to the 25th. That's this weekend with the Panache Desai Global Gathering. And so
there's
we've talked a lot about
tickets left. I know of a handful of people that just got their tickets like today. So there are tickets available.
Yes, and we would love to have
you. No more hotel rooms at the resort, but they're offshoots.
Yeah, and even Airbnb is a perfect option. You know, I'm sure you're going to be able to find something in Phoenix, Arizona, and you might even be local. So you'd be able to just pop in and come to the global gathering. You will get so much information, so much inspiration. And if you want to learn a little bit more, head to the astrological interview with Jan Desai. She'll tell you a lot more about that. Then August 30th, to October 18th. I know this is a big time span, but this is the Constellation Bracelet Workshop. And we just discussed this a little bit, but this is an entire bracelet that is made with 12 different intentions just for you and what you're working on. I can't stress it enough. We would love to have you, you know, come aboard. It's a small, intimate group where we work at sometimes like random times and days.
And, you know, you ask me, and maybe Emily, you know, asking me about how, you know, like a resource book or how do I learn more? This is one of the ways to work directly with me and the small group. And when we say small group, it's like no more than eight.
Right.
Eight's our maximum. And so it's really small, yet very personal. And this is a really good way to have the one-on-one contact to help learn through your own dealings of the day.
Right. Yeah. And so, of course, link is in the description. And we also have the Wanderlust Festival coming here to Chicago, Illinois.
Downtown.
Right downtown.
Grand Park.
Right at Grand Park. It is wonderful. Everyone does yoga. There's a, you know, mindful triathlon with running, yoga, and meditation. And this is a now two-day festival. And it's just so cool to have this bustling city happening around you where, you know, we're almost in a little bubble and a container.
It's like concrete jungle all over there. And then you turn your back to it and all you see is water.
Mm-hmm. It's beautiful.
And you watch these boats just kind of moving on the water. You see the Ferris wheel going around. It looks like playland on one side and serious business in the concrete land.
Yes.
Right? So right in the middle in this beautiful green, very foresty, flowery. We're all doing yoga. I'm teaching
yeah,
astrology.
We'll be teaching our astrology classes, astrology 101, 202, and 303.
Okay. Which are the signs, planets, and the wheel.
Of course. So we would love for you to join. Head over to wanderlust.com to learn more about tickets. Then we have our Unhustle Retreat coming up in Lake Tahoe, September 19th through the 22nd. This is our Burnout to Peace Out Hustle, Unhustle.
International Peace Day on that, right in the middle there, the 21st.
Right.
So, you know, I'll be going over the Mercury and everybody's charts and seeing how your thinking, your communication, your you know, meanderings within the brain, you know, your mental activity is moving and how best to support that in the way that you think and you communicate versus what the world is trying to tell you to do.
Right. And this is very important information. So today is the last day in order to have your lodging totally booked. So if you're an out-of-towner and you are not from Lake Tahoe or around the surrounding area, make sure to call in today for your Unhustle Retreat attendance because we need to give away the rooms if we don't have them, and that is happening today. So of course, be sure to email me info@intentionbeads.com if you are interested in the retreat, and I can put a little hold on a room for you.
Right, so, and then you would sign up and get a short 15-minute little briefing looking at your chart with me.
Mm-hmm.
And Milena, our co-creator, is also offering a 30-minute coaching session.
Right.
If you're interested in going to the retreat. This is all, you know, pro bono to let you know a little bit about how I teach and how Milena teaches and let us get to know a little bit about you.
Right. And
before you even decide that you can actually make it.
And so it's also a wonderful time to really like kind of test the waters and see if you would be a good fit for this retreat. Mm-hmm. So come aboard. We would love to have you. And let's move into our final segment, our house.
There's a lot going on here. I mean, I really have to say, I'm going to talk about Mars, transiting Mars, crossed over my ascendant. I have a Leo ascendant. Mars crosses this line for everybody once every 2 years, always on a different time. So I'm like watching, and it was going to happen on Friday morning, and I'm watching, I'm thinking, oh my gosh, I had a fly that day. I had like 3 flights to catch, and I'm like, oh man, this is not Mars. You know, Mars is the planet of action and movement and sometimes force, you know, assertiveness versus aggressiveness, right? So I'm like, well, about 30 hours prior to that, I am getting out of the car. In this Mars on ascendant, it's not anything that's like a big accident.
Like your head gets chopped off.
No, it's not a big accident. It's just a little bit of a, like, I've once, you know, bumped my knee on the coffee table, but got a huge hematoma, right? The one time somebody stepped on my foot on the dance floor, you know, and I like, yeah, that was.
And then you retired your dancing shoes after that.
Yeah, it was like, I'm done. I gotta sit down now. I'll have another drink. But so 30 hours before, I get out of the car and twist my knee, where my knee is locked up. I couldn't even straighten it out. So I'm trying to walk, and I'm like, I kind of had to fall over into the car.
Man.
And the person I'm trying to catch up with doesn't even know that my knee is like bent back, and I can't, ouch. I'm like hopping.
Ouch, ouch, ouch.
And so I take my knee and I go, whoosh, right, to like straighten like it out.
Kick really fast?
Yeah, like a mule kick forward. I don't know. And I'm
forward? That's a good.
I don't know. I'm not a Rockette or anything, like I think there's a
kickboxer kick forward.
Kick that just like unkinks your knee. I did that, and I went and sat for dinner, and my knee blew up to the size of this. Ooh. And I literally had to take wheelchairs. So those 3 flights I had to catch was wheelchair to the flight, that flight into a wheelchair to the next flight, wheelchair to the next. That's how I got home.
Wow.
So, you know, watch for Mars on the ascendant, because I, you know, if you're doing a reading with me, I'm going to give you the date if it's coming up.
Of course, yeah.
But all that means is just pay attention to some sort of energy that is coming to you that you need to engage with, right? But it oftentimes will kind of get you.
Yeah.
Interesting. Bummer. So anyway, that's it. And it's better. I've iced it. I've rubbed my, you know, my CBD oil all over it, and it's lessening, and I can actually walk on it now. So okay. I'm good.
Good, good. I'm very happy about that.
Yeah.
So we all know that Jupiter is now in, you know, back in action, forward movement. And so I got this wonderful news from my boyfriend about Huggy Time. And Huggy Time is now catching on. It's now a thing. You know,
it's growing. It's expanding.
We had even Emily in the Going Direct had mentioned, I hope your family Huggy Time is loving and amazing and all of the good things. And also I heard from Rocco's sister, she was listening to the podcast at work, and she was, you know, she told her coworkers, hey, I can put my earbuds in and just listen by myself, but I'm going to listen to this podcast. It's kind of like about astrology and blah, blah, blah. And so they're like, oh no, we like podcasts. Let's listen to it. And so they listened to it, figured out that her brother was on that episode. She didn't even know he was going to be on that episode. And now her coworkers are like, Huggy Time, it's Huggy Time.
And they all get up and hug?
I think so. And if they don't, they definitely should, because that is all
that's what it's
Huggy
about.
Time is about.
Yeah.
So if you guys are listening to that in that office space right now.
Right now.
Start it up.
Right
get
now.
Some Huggy Time action.
And send a video or at least a photo. Really, everybody, you know, Huggy Time, right? Call for it. You know, and which means everybody drops their attitude, whatever they have in their hands, and they just do a hug.
Yeah. And
just do it. And then you can put your head to the side. You don't have to kiss. We didn't call it kissy time, right? Just hug, feel that, and move back to what you were doing.
Right. And it's kind of like there's that infectious laugh of somebody who, you know, you can't help but drop your attitude and drop the worries that you're going through in your mind just to kind of join in and laugh yourself. So that is what Huggy Time is about. It's about being here in the moment. Whoever's around you, just give them a quick touch, give them a quick embrace, and that's, and that's all, what it's about.
You should claim, though, it's Huggy Time,
it's
right?
Huggy
and
time.
Then everybody knows that it's like, oh, this is a thing? Maybe this is one of those new ice bucket challenges.
Ice bucket challenge? The Huggy Time challenge?
Yeah, the Huggy Time challenge. Wherever you are, hug whoever's in the
yes,
room, right?
Maybe we should make it a hashtag. Hashtag Huggy Time challenge. So, okay. And also, so Jupiter going direct too, I thought this was so interesting. Something popped up on my news feed and it was about Amelia Earhart and her airplane crash. And so it's from the New York Times and it was basically, you know, it's been so long and this is one of 20th century's greatest mysteries of like, where did her plane go and why have we not been able to find it? There were so many different, you know, rescue missions to go and either help her, find her. And then after a while, they just decided that she, you know, was deceased and she was lost in the ocean, unfortunately. But it turns out that so Richard Ballard, who has found the Titanic and other like very famous shipwrecks, has gotten a little clue about where Amelia Earhart's airplane could be.
Woo! Ooh, goosebumps.
Isn't that crazy? So this like kind of international discovery is, you know, on the precipice and it's about to happen because for the square mileage of, you know, where her route was and where her plane could have been, you know, detracked, he wasn't about to go and start this mission yet. And so he got a tip from somebody who, I think it was like maybe satellite pictures, had seen a little piece of this specific type of airplane that she was flying at the time. And it was the landing gear.
Mm.
So there, you know, and it could have been where the plane was just like kind of like destroyed and in many pieces. But they're like, oh my gosh, this is a clue. We're going to start the search around this area. So they're going to start that mission of trying to discover Amelia Earhart and her plane.
Wow.
How crazy is that?
That's amazing.
I'm pretty excited. Well, and, you know, Amelia Earhart, she is the epitome of Jupiter in Sagittarius, taking an entire flight around the world. I mean, that's pretty impressive.
Yeah, very empowerment. Yeah, that's female. That's the goddess power as well.
Yes. Right. So I guess we'll stay tuned on, you know, if they can find anything. And I'm sure we'll all be notified when and if that happens.
You'll either tell us here, Alex, or we'll just see it on Netflix.
Of course, I'll let you know. Yeah, so I think that's the wrap of our Jupiter and Sagittarius.
Oh, I was going to talk about what happened today when you went to the dentist.
Okay, let's talk about it. So, okay, during our travels to Bali, somehow chipped my tooth. And I am not a vain person, but when you chip your front tooth, you can't hide it.
Well, and you have such a beautiful smile. You've had the braces. We've been all over your teeth the minute you got them, right?
And so as soon as I just discovered this, and I wasn't sure when or how it happened, it wasn't like I tripped and, you know, fell on some pavement. It just happened. And so I've been trying to bond it and nothing's really like working.
It breaks off again. So I take you today to the dentist with me.
Mm-hmm.
And you are thinking about, oh my God, this bonding is not working. Let me go see a dentist, a professional to see if I need to
file the whole tooth down.
Which means your other
tooth. My other tooth too, which would mean that all the four of my teeth are like pretty much straight across. And that's when, so okay, long story short, I didn't decide to do it. I am going to stick with the bonds and let's see how this can work out. However, the filing of the teeth, you and I, when we were discussing it, reminded us a lot about the Balinese practice of tooth filing.
Yes, it's a big ceremony.
It is. It's huge. And it's a, everybody it's a rite of does passage. It. Yeah. And so if I had to file my teeth down, I was going to create it into some sort of like spiritual practice mm-hmm. of venturing into adulthood. And yes, I am an adult. I'm 31. I know. But it in Bali, when we were there, we've noticed that everyone has very straight teeth, straight across.
Yeah. And on their top, the top teeth.
Right. And so this is a sign of spirituality, purity, where, you know, it's said that in the like Hindu Balinese, that when you have like the curved or the fang like teeth, it's more animalistic. And that when you're, you know, headed up to the pearly white gates, they might mistake you for an animal. Or one of the, you know, kind of demons, and you'll be cast back down. And so I just thought it was really interesting. It's when a girl gets her first menstruation, or a boy, when his voice starts to change. And we have a friend in Bali, Koman, who got his teeth filed down. And luckily his wife is a dentist.
She's actually my dentist when I go there. But he was telling me the story that he made his own decision. He volunteered the time when he thought he was a man, not just when his voice was changing, where it's when the family say, okay, son, or okay, daughter, it's time. We're going to put the ceremony together. We're going to put this, we're going to get the boneyard together and the community, and the priest does it. Mm-hmm. It's kind of quite painful, I understand, because they don't use an electric type of sander drill.
It's a manual file.
And Koman had decided that he waited a little bit longer and said, okay, I'm now a man. I can take on the responsibility of myself, the people that I want in my world, my wife that I'm going to marry one day, my duties and my responsibilities. I'm a man now. And he chose when that was. But I understand from what he was saying that if you don't do it, if your parents don't do this as a family practice.
Because it is kind of an expensive ceremony.
Yeah. That, and you don't voluntarily decide when to do it, that it's often done, you know, after you're dead.
Yeah, sometimes it is.
So if you don't have your teeth filed in Bali, at the time of the cremation, you have it done after your death, before the cremation, so that your soul is readily welcomed, you know, into the afterlife.
Right.
So, and so anyway, it was a really big, really big conversation that Alex and I have been having over this last couple of weeks. Like, just come with me to the dentist. He'll do it. I've already talked to him. He agreed to see you.
Yes.
And then we were driving in today, and you're like,
I was in the dentist's chair. I was all ready to go. I was like, kind of like trying to pep myself up. But in the back of my mind, I just kept saying, I don't want my smile to change. I don't want my smile to change. Mm-hmm. And so it is such a big part of me. And I have, you know, decided to just put the bill on some more bonding. So right. I'll let you know how that works.
Even the doctor came into my room where I was having some things done, and he said, your daughter is so beautiful. I won't touch her teeth. I cannot file her teeth down. I'm going to send her to another dentist who she'll pay a bigger price, but his bonding is bonding.
Top notch.
Top bond.
Yes. Yeah. So yes, that's my tooth filing story and the tooth filing rituals in Bali. So that is all for our episode today. Of course, we want to keep in touch with you guys. Let us know if you even have had your teeth filed down or had any chipped teeth, because I need to feel some support over here. So of course, email me info@intentionbeads.com. Head over to Instagram, @intentionbeads. And we will see you next week. I hope you guys have a wonderful week ahead.
Talk to you next week.